Okay. This ionization energy is also termed as ionization enthalpy. Okay. And it is written something like this. H stands for enthalpy, delta stands for change. So, this is change in enthalpy, ION stands for ionization, this circle stands for standard conditions. Standard conditions over here are 298 Kelvin and 1 atmosphere. Okay. And when you say ionization energy, you simply use I dot E dot, ionization energy. Okay, brother? Fine. Now, what is ionization energy? Let us take a very simple, let me give you the definition first. The definition is that it is the minimum amount of energy required to remove an electron from the outermost shell of an isolated gaseous atom. So, what all I am saying over here, beta? See, I am saying that first point, it is the minimum energy. It is the minimum energy, fine, for removing electron outermost shell isolated atom and gaseous atom. Now, these are the keywords over here. Now, why are we talking about isolated gaseous atom? If you understand the point of isolated gaseous atom, automatically minimum energy and all everything will come into the picture. So, let us take an example. Say I am teaching in the class and you guys are sitting and you know, my dear Santa Singh is making a lot of noise. He is creating a lot of nuisance in the class. So, now I really get angry. I say, Santa, I have to take you out of the class. Okay. So, what I do is I hold his hand and try to pull him out of the class. I hold his hand and try to pull him out of the class. But to my surprise, Santa Singh is loved by everybody who is sitting around Santa Singh. So, while I am trying to pull Santa Singh out of the class, rest of the students hold on to his pants. No, sir, no, sir, please, sir. Santa Singh is our friend, sir. Please, 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 please don't take him out. No, 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 I am going to throw him out. And no, 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 sir, please, please, please. But I am really very furious, I am adamant. So, I apply maximum amount of energy whatever I can. Which energy? Maximum. What is written over here? Minimum. Oh, okay, okay. Anyways. But I apply maximum amount of energy and then I take this boy out of the class. That is case number one. When you say isolated, what do you mean? Now, this case is a case when one atom is surrounded by, one atom is surrounded by a large number of other atoms, as it happens in the case of solids. So, if you want to remove an electron from here, what will happen? This atom, this atom, this atom, this atom, this atom. All these atoms will try to pull the electron towards them. So, I have to apply the energy not only of this atom, but the attractions shown by the rest of the atoms also, right? You got my point? So, that is why the amount of energy required is very high. Case 2. Now, there is a boy in the class who is really a nuisance maker, teases everybody, you know. So, nobody is happy with him. Nobody is happy with him. Now he was making nuisance in my class, and I said, I'm gonna throw you out. The moment I said, I'm gonna throw you out, rest all the students said, yes sir, throw him out. Throw him out, sir. If you don't won't throw, we will throw him out of the class. So now in this case, I just have to hold the hand of this boy who's a naughty one and take him out. Now in this case, the energy required is minimum energy. Which one? Minimum. So that is why when you're talking about outermost shell, because see, the outermost shell is farthest away from the nucleus. So to remove this, you require minimum energy. Minimum But this electron which is inside, this requires higher energy to be taken out. And those people who are not able to understand this part, I will give you electrostatic force of attractions formula. F is equal to k q1 q2 by r square. So as the value of radius increases, the electrostatic force of attraction decreases. If the electrostatic force or radius increases, means the distance increases, the force of attraction decreases. So this is experiencing minimum attraction, so you require minimum energy to take it out. But at the same time, so this is the outermost shell. Now this shell is the outermost shell. So that is why I require outermost shell. Second, I require isolated atom. Why? Because in case of liquid or solid, one atom is surrounded by a large number of other atoms. So when you try to take out an electron from one atom, the rest of the nucleus, which are the neighbors of this atom, they will try to pull it back. Okay. So that is why we require isolated gaseous atom and outermost shell. Automatically the energy will be minimum. Tell me, is this clear to everybody? The ionization energy depends on atomic radius. How? The ionization energy is inversely proportional to atomic radius. So smaller the atomic radius, higher the ionization energy. Okay. As a result of which, I can say that if I move from left to right in a period, left to right in a period, the radius decreases. Sorry, the radius decreases, but the ionization energy increases. Down the group, the ionization energy decreases. Okay, so from here you can say that cesium is having the least ionization energy in periodic table. Okay, and that way helium has IE1 of alkali metals is lowest in the respective period, whereas I1 of noble gases is highest in the respective period. Okay.